Howdy y'all, Neshi Nickangtel here with the Crystal Beast Traps tier list. I like making these videos about the tier lists of the different cards in the Crystal Beast archetype, maybe cards that aren't played enough or aren't talked about in the Crystal Beast archetype because, you know, they aren't very good or they aren't really discussed. So these videos kind of give me an opportunity to do that and share my opinion and my thoughts about them. So without further ado, let's get into it, starting off with Crystal Counter or Counter Gem. You know, I gotta be honest, this one is definitely F tier because I've never once resolved this in my life in a duel. If you have, comment below, but honestly I never have. A lot of these are going to be really trash tier cards. Like, some of these cards are really horrible. Well, here we go. The only good Crystal Beast trap though, Crystal Conclave. This is the only one that's S tier because it just does so much for the deck. It's a gas card. When a Crystal Beast card is destroyed, special summon a Pegasus from deck, get another Pegasus in the back row, and then it's a disruption card. Pitch the Conclave to grave, target the Pegasus in your back row and another card your opponent controls, bounce them to hand, summon Pegasus the next turn for an OTK. It's such an amazing card that does a lot for the archetype. Honestly, if it was a continuous spell card, it'd be busted. But it's a trap, so it's a little bit, you know, good. It's a little bit balanced. Next up, we have Crystal Pear. Now, this card would be a little bit better if some of its text isn't changed. It's going to be F tier. Like, it's not good at all. If one part of its text changed, I believe it says, when a Crystal Beast monster is destroyed by battle and sent to the graveyard, then place one from deck, then you don't take battle damage for the rest of the turn. If the Crystal Beast didn't have to go to the graveyard and instead it got to go under its usual effect and get placed in the spell and trap zone, then it might be a little bit better. It won't be a neg. It's such a huge neg, oh my gosh. But it's just not that great. It'd probably still be F tier if it had that effect, but, you know, I don't understand why it said the Crystal Beast has to go to the graveyard after it's destroyed. Next up, Crystal Raigeki. This is actually a pretty decent card, but it's B tier. It doesn't do a lot. It's still a neg 1, but, like, it's disruption on your opponent's turn. It gives the Crystal Beast in the back row some type of value, and it's good in Duel Links and just solid B tier card. This is Cut Jewel in the anime, but it's actually added in Duel Links as Crystal Slicer. So it's a real legal card in Duel Links, so that's why I added it in the video. I'm going to put it as D tier. So if you don't know Crystal Slicer, it says something along the lines of when... So it's a trap card, you get to send a Crystal Beast from deck to grave, and then halve an opponent's monster's attack, and that's permanent attack halving. But then your opponent just gets to draw a free card. So it's like, why am I just giving my opponent a free card from halving their attack? And then you also get to send a Crystal Beast from deck to grave, like I said, so it could be good for Rainbow Dragon Turbo. But like, your opponent getting a free draw, I was going to put it in F tier, but I talked with my brother Richard about it and we agreed that it was D tier. So you win this round, Crystal Slicer. You're not even in the actual TCG, but the Crystal Beasts just don't have enough trap cards. I mean, look, we have Triggered Summon, for crying out loud. Like, I just wanted to add in some fun cards like this. Crystal Slicer, Triggered Summon, because it's an honorary Jesse card. But here we go, Last Resort. Now, this card is literally the last resort I would play in a Crystal Beast deck. If I'm ever going to really be desperate enough to search out Rainbow Ruins and risk my opponent getting a free draw, like, I have to be playing max copies of Terraforming, max Metaverse, max Set Rotation, maybe like even a couple copies of Demise of the Land. Even then, like, maybe I'll play Last Resort, but we have so many field spell searches that, like, this card is very outdated for sure. We don't need to play it at all. Please don't play this in your Crystal Beast decks. I guess if you're playing like Trap Trick, and then since Metaverse is at 1, maybe, but like, please don't play this. This is literally the last resort field spell searcher in the game. And then we have Rainbow Gravity. Rainbow Gravity, I'm gonna put it above Crystal. Screw this card. Rainbow Gravity is pretty decent, like, for how bad it is, because you can, it's one of the only cards in the game that can reborn a rainbow dragon. So I guess that's kind of neat. You can get search it off trap trick and summon one from deck or grave. So it's all right. Rainbow Path. I'm going to think I want to put it at F tier, but in Duel Links, it's like one of the only ways that you could search Rainbow Dragon besides Melody. So I might put it bottom of D tier, just because like I have resolved it a couple times in Duel Links, and you get to add that Rainbow Dragon, so it's not like a neg. It kind of is a neg, because you have to send a Crystal Beast from your Spell and Trap Zone to the graveyard. Yeah, it's not a good card at all. Like, D minus tier, borderline into F tier, but like, just because I've used it in Duel Links a couple times, I'm going to put it in D tier. Triggered Summon. I'll say it's a C tier card. Sure, you get a special summon from your hand, then your opponent gets one too, but like, I don't know, I guess you can combo with Conclave if you don't have any Crystal Beasts. You can summon a Pegasus from hand, and then now you have fodder. Now you have resources for Conclave, so I guess I'll put it as a C tier card. It's just in here just because Jesse used it. And then final, should I really put it at C tier? No, I think it's D tier. It's like top of D tier though. Finally, we have Ultimate Crystal Magic. This is a good card. It just requires so much. It requires a Crystal Beast to be destroyed by battle. I'll put this guy up here. Yeah, I want to put it at C tier, but like, it's good at what it does. It's very explosive. I'll actually put it at top of B tier. Yeah, I think that's correct. I think it's just too good of a card for what it does to not put it in anything lower than B tier. But just being a Crystal Beast destroyed by battle, that's like very laughable, and it's a trap card, so you can't even activate it going second. So those are my reasons for why it should just stay in B tier. But I hope you guys like this video. This is the Crystal Beast Traps tier list. If you have any changes you'd like to make to it, let me know in the comment section. If you want to just yell at me for not having anything in the A tier and screwing up the whole tier list, go for it. And if you want to tell me your spicy tech that you have with Last Resort or any of these cards, Counter Gem could be potential, but like, if you have that spicy tech, let me know. I kind of doubt it, but at the same time, I believe that someone out there is trying to make Last Resort work. But make sure to subscribe to my channel for more Crystal Beast content, and make sure to join the Crystal Beast Facebook group so that you can join in on the Crystal Beast discussion. I'll see you guys in the next video.